Hey everyone, it's Lori here at the Land of Color, and I just wanted to pop in really quickly to address a couple things that I noticed here on our forum. So we have a new member, and she posted for the first time. Her name is NE Home Color. I think that's probably Northeast Home Color. And Colette Harrison, who is a color strategist who completed my Camp Chroma course, is chiming in to help her out. So I noticed a couple things in her last post that I might be able to help out with. So I decided to make this video and see what I could do. So first of all, she mentioned that she's considering river reflections, but it's not in the color DNA table, which isn't a problem. I can go in there and I can get that color added for her pretty quickly. I'll do it after I'm done with this video. And if you find yourself in that same situation where a color isn't in the color DNA table that you're looking for, you can just post here in the forum to let me know, or you can send me an email. We can usually get colors added the same day. So that's an easy one. We'll take care of that. So moving on to a bigger question. I'm going to read the paragraph to you so you know where we are here. So she says, I'm not sure I'm entirely understanding how to plot the colors on the color wheel using the DNA values in order to understand if a color is to the right or left of the highest concentration of the hue family, the five position. So I have a color wheel right here. If you look at it, the big dots are 5Y. In every hue family, and the big dots are there because they mark on the color wheel where the highest concentration of the hue parent is perceived. So that's what she's talking about when she's referring to the position, the five position. I'm confused about the hue angle and hue sector. For instance, BM Sag Harbor Gray is hue angle 91 and hue of 2.92. We'll call that 3. The hue angle of 91 would put it slightly on the right side of 5Y toward green-yellow. However, 3, 2.92, I said we'd call it 3. We're going to call it 3. 3 is on the left of 5Y, putting it toward the yellow-orange hue family. On the color wheel, it's not yellow-orange, it's yellow-red YR, but that's okay. I know what she means. I'm missing some information to better understand how to use the DNA tool, but can't seem to find it on the site. This is a common question. She can't find it on the site because I don't talk about it much. These details are inside my Camp Chroma course. However, I understand that the Camp Chroma course might be a little much for some people. They're not looking to get certified as a color strategist, and they're looking for less information. And I am working on developing additional content for people who are looking for more capsule information, maybe just about hue, value, chroma, and the color strategist color wheel. So I've heard you. I've gotten all those emails and I'm working on it. So I'm going to try to get something delivered here pretty soon. In the meantime, let me explain this to you. So the color strategist color wheel is like two color wheels in one, right? So here it is again. On the outside of the color wheel, we have LCH hue angle, and on the inside, we have Munsell hue families. Two different color spaces, two different color systems. Munsell was the template for the LCH C-Lab, technically. The C-Lab color space, LCH is just one format of C-Lab, but Munsell was the template for LCH, which is why we can integrate both of them onto one color wheel. So that's why the color strategist color wheel is like two color wheels in one. They don't always align. Toggling back and forth between the two systems, between Munsell and LCH, the math is messy. It doesn't always work out evenly. It's not perfect. There isn't perfect alignment. There's almost never perfect alignment. But let me tell you why it's a good thing and why it's and how you can use that information. So having two different numbers isn't a problem. So you have 91 degrees and a Munsell hue family of 3Y in the case of Sag Harbor Gray. So having two color systems on one wheel is kind of like having two friends in real life who are really good with color. And if you were to ask those two friends, hey, what do you guys think of BM Sag Harbor Gray? Where would you put it on the color wheel? Well, one might say, hey, you know, I think it's closer to the yellow-red hue family. And the other friend might say, no, I don't agree with that. I think it's closer to the green-yellow hue family. So it's actually very representative of how people see color in real life, because we don't all see color the same way. So the reason why I include both numbers, both notations, the hue angle and the Munsell Hue family in the color DNA table is so that you're aware of that range. It's like, hey, it could be anywhere between 5Y, 6Y, and 3Y here. And when you think about it, that's not a whole lot of space, right? That's less than 5 or 10 degrees. I don't know. I haven't counted. I could take a look. Do you want me to take a look? I'll take a look right now. So let's see. She said it was 91 degrees. And 3Y is at about 83 degrees. So that's probably 7 or 8 degrees difference. That's not a huge spread there. We're still in the yellow hue family. But as she mentions, one puts you closer to the yellow-red hue family with yellow-red overtones, and then the other number puts you closer to green-yellow with green-yellow overtones. So like, which one do you pay attention to? Yeah, it's a range, that's great, but how do you analyze? How do you distill down that information? Well, based on the range that we have between 80 degrees and 91 degrees, I would assume from that data that VM Sag Harbor Gray probably leans more to yellow-red overtones because of the range that we have to work with here. So you know, the numbers don't interpret themselves, and we can't color by the numbers alone. Someone has to analyze that data. It requires a creative human linchpin to visually assess those colors. This is just a framework. So that's how you use the framework of 91 degrees and a Munsell Hue family of 2.92. That's how I would use that framework. That's how I would use that range. And I would use that information to analyze Sag Harbor Gray in the space. And now you're aware that, hey, this could lean a little yellow-red. This could look a little, it could look a little peachy. It could have moments, flashes of pink. It could even have flashes of purple, because we know near neutrals from that yellow-red hue family range, that zone, sometimes shift purple. Or it could look just gray if it's leaning more green-yellow overtones, more into that green-yellow hue family. It's going to show up looking more gray than anything else. So that's how we use that information, and I hope you found that helpful. And thanks so much for posting in the forum and asking such great questions, any home color. I'll talk to you guys later.